talked a little bit in this class about perimeter and area before, but I want to go over them just one more time and sort of summarize it for you, along with another measurement that we use, which is volume. So, to summarize, perimeter is the outside measurement of an object, and that's back in lesson two that we started talking about it. For most objects, all you have to do is add the sides up to get the perimeter, but for circles, you can't add the sides. The formula is perimeter equals pi times diameter. And when we state perimeter, we always state it as plane units. That's just to help you remember. For area, that's the inside measurement of an object. We did this one in lesson five. For a rectangle, the area formula is length times width. For circles, the formula is area equals pi times r squared. And we always state area as square units. So now let's look at area just a second. I want to go over that with you. If I said told you to find the area of a circle that had a radius of 2 inches, let me draw a circle here. And my radius, of course, is only halfway across. So here's my radius, and it's 2 inches. Now, the area of the circle, always write your formula down. Area is equal to pi times r squared. And I know pi is 3.14, and I know this radius is 2, and I'm going to have to square it. So area for this circle is going to be 3.14 times 2 squared. I would do that first because exponents come before multiplication in order of operations, right? So I'd say 2 times 2, or 4. Then all I have to do is multiply 3.14 times 4. 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times 1 is 4 plus the 1 I carry, 5. 4 times 3 is 12. I need two decimal places because I have two decimal places in my multiplicands. And so it's 12.56 is what area is equal to. Area would equal 12.56. And remember, I told you, area is always square units. And we used inches here. We started with inches, so we have to end with inches. So what if they tell you, instead of the radius of a circle, they give you another circle. And this time they tell you that the diameter of this circle all the way across is 2 inches. Well, area, the formula didn't change. Area is equal to pi times radius squared. Once again, I know pi, it's 3.14. But I've got to know the radius so that I can square it. Well, the entire diameter all the way across the circle is 2. Halfway across my circle would be 1, because 1 plus 1 would equal 2. So that is my formula filled in. Now, if I want to square 1, which I do, all I'm really going to come up with is area is equal to 3.14 times 1. And that means that area is going to equal 3.14 square, and it was inches again, so it's going to be square inches. So if they tell you that on diameter, you know you have to take half of it to get the radius, and then you have to square it. Remember, there's a difference in multiplying by 2 and squaring something. So be sure you have that straight in your head when you start working these problems. Okay, let's talk about volume. All we have to do for volume is add one more unit. And I'm sorry it didn't print correctly on my sheet here. What it is volume is equal to length times width times, and that should be an H, height. Length times width times height. And volume is stated as cubic units. So let's say we have a box. I'll try to draw one. It's not just a box, it's a three-dimensional box. So maybe I can draw that for you. Now, we've got three measurements that'll tell us the inside volume of that box. We've got the length. Let's say the length is down here. It doesn't matter which is which. We've got the height, which is this measurement, and we've got the width. We'll call this the width. Those three measurements are necessary for getting the volume of our box because volume is equal to length times width times height. All right. Volume is equal to, let's say length in this one, they gave us the measurements 4 by 4 by 5 by 3. It could be any of them. Let's say length was 4 and width is 5 and height is 3. So I would put those in, 4 times 5 times 3, and then I just do multiplication. 4 times 5 is 20 times 3. So volume is really equal to 20 times 3, or 60. And remember, it is cubic, whatever the units is, and this unit was inches.